Ladies and gentlemen, come gather around, come gather around, come gather around. Today, Santa's arrived, and he's got something new for the 61 Chevy pickup. Woo! Let's have a look. Oh, it's heavy too. Looks like it's been significantly dropped. Although the outside box is fine. That's weird. So this, boys and girls, is a limited slip differential. More specifically, you Chevy guys like to call them a posse, but Chevy has their own style. Okay, there's a lot of different styles of limited slips. When you got your vehicle and you got to go around a corner, one wheel has to turn faster than the other to go around a corner, because this one's going to go around a bigger radius. It's got to go faster, kind of like when you're playing crack the whip out on the ice. You're like all holding hands. One guy's at the end going like super slow, and the guy at the eight, like 12 people away, is doing Mach 8 in circles around the rink. That's how you get kicked off the ice. Ask me how I know. On a vehicle, it has a differential which allows you to go around a corner and have wheels turning at different speeds. If you put a lot of power to it, by the very nature of a differential, all that power is going to go to the wheel that has no traction, and they call that the one wheel peel, the one tire fire, and it just scorches one tire, usually the right rear. There's different ways to limit the slip of that wheel. Some manufacturers put little clutches in to give it a little bit of friction, which can be increased when you accelerate. Magic. There's other ones that have like a cone that kind of wedges into something, kind of like more tapered drill bits or the tailstock on the lathe. Some manufacturers use a locker, which locks like this, and they lock into place. When you accelerate it, it's like locked, and you go freaking straight or sideways. And when you go around a corner, the outside wheel kind of freewheels and goes click, 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 so it can go faster, and it's noisier going around corners. Good for dirt, drift, or drag, but probably not the best for the street. This one's my favorite. This is a helical diff, and it's freaking black magic and voodoo. I can't even explain in a paragraph how it works. There's like the axles come in, there's side gears, there's a collection of crazy worm gears and things that blah, 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 and it drives both wheels with a difference in speed, but the same torque to both wheels. It's voodoo. I bought one. Lucky us! You can't see inside, which is probably for the best. This one is a Detroit TrueTrac made by Eaton. Comes with an instruction book, but who's going to read that? And for a 9-inch Ford differential, it looks like this. When you're taking these out, you can reuse your ring and pinion. You just take the ring gear off, put your ring gear on this one, put it back together. Adjust the backlash of the movement. We'll get into that. I've tried to save the original bearings off the old differential. Don't do that. Just buy new ones. And we'll assemble this. Oh my gosh, it's heavy. And greasy. These are the carrier bearings. The whole differential thing that carries the differential is called the carrier. So that's the carrier. I got two new bearings. There's lots of bearing companies. Timken is like the gold standard of bearings. So I've got a set of Timkens, and I'm gonna press those onto this, and we're gonna punch it into the pumpkin from the 9-inch Ford. Bring it on, let's go. It's October. It's getting a little chilly. Snow's gonna come out. I'm even wearing clothing underneath this. In many parts of Canada, October is sliding in the ditch month. To celebrate, we're gonna put a limited slip differential in this butte right here. So with a little bit of finagling, I got this thing down to where I can see It looks like about 15 thousandths. The allowable backlash is 10 to 16. And I'd say we're at 15. Things aren't really adding up here. This is the old diff. If you look inside, you can see like kind of block, some kind of a block apparatus inside there. And if you look in here through the other side, you can see two sets of splines, and you can see the recessed nature of these bolt holes. And I think also this rough cast and machined, this is a limited slip. So I pulled out a limited slip to put in a limited slip. Exciting times. Woo! However, one way to test to see how these things work, you turn one wheel, and if the other wheel goes in the opposite direction, it's an open diff. If it goes in the same direction, it's a limited slip. And this one was testing like an open diff, which tells me it's pooched. And to be honest, the oil coming out of this kind of stinks like clutches. So it's not a limited slip differential, it's a slip differential. Future me interrupting to share with why you shouldn't do what I do, what you see here. This axle has a 3.50 to 1 gear ratio, which is a semi-hunting gear ratio, which means in a full rotation of the ring gear, the teeth on the pinion engage in certain gears or certain teeth, not all the teeth. So you need to pay attention to how it was aligned when you take it apart. Otherwise, Lord howdy, good luck mashing those teeth back to where they're supposed to be. Lucky for me, there is a mark on the pinion, which I can show you in a moment. I haven't found the one on the ring gear yet, so I hope I can find it. Found it. Right there. A new diff like this doesn't come with bearings, so you buy the bearings and then you press them on. With any luck. Practice to take a little bit of a stone, rub it on the surface to take off any high spots. And we'll hit up the back of the gear as well. I think some instructions say to use a file, but this is hardened steel, I think. Probably not this surface. So interestingly, because this truck had a limited slip, the bolts are different. And these bolts are too long to fit through here into the ring gear. So, through the wonders of Visa, I got a different set of bolts. Lucky me. Congratulations, you found an immunity idol. What? To make this, you got 5/16 holes on a 2 3/16 circle. I went to go make one. Turns out I have one of these in my scrap pile. Lucky me. So you turn these until you just see the outer race of the bearing turn, and then you know you're at zero. And then you got to go one more circle on each side, and that should give you your 5/1000ths preload per side. Then, with the preload on the carrier bearings, you got to check. You can hear it, but you can't measure a sound. So, dial indicator to the rescue. And I think I want to go on this side, like so. Here's what I do. Well, I don't always get lucky, but when I do, apparently it's with a Ford. Boom! I better check that number. So if you look down here, you see kind of a red painted tooth on the pinion inside there. That's important. And it keys into a spot on the ring gear, which you can see those two little divots on the inside of the ring gear. Those line up with the tooth that you need to mesh with. Otherwise, this thing's gonna make noise and ain't nothing you're gonna do gonna stop it. So get it right. We'll be right back. Thus ends the installation of the Eaton Detroit TrueTrac limited slip differential, torsen helical style limited slip. One of my all-time favorites. Not my favorite install this go around, but one of my favorite limited slips. Let me know in the comments below what your favorite LSD is. Unless you had too much 60s during the acid, in which case, leave two comments, one of which needs to be blurry. Thanks for watching.